Hello, I would like to welcome you to our webinar related to dividend trading with TWS and TradeStation as well. Just for the beginning, a few facts. First, a disclaimer that this is not an investment advice or trading recommendation. My name is Christian Walter. I think from the last videos or webinars, you might know already these details, so that we can start with our topic. What is a dividend? Dividend is a profit distribution as a payment to all co-owners of the company. And there's a simple example. If a company has $10 million profit and the CEO decides to pay a 2% of dividend to shareholders, $200,000 will be distributed to the shareholders. And below you can see the exact example. If you're holding 6 shares of $150 each, the calculation is the following. We will calculate $150 multiplied by 6 shares, it's total $900, and then 10% of this $900 is $18 dividend payment. And I think this is a very easy and simple explanation. Most people of you might already heard about or know this already. So let us go to the next slide. Most companies, they pay dividends once a year or quarterly. I think in the US it's in general every 3 months. In Germany, for example, it's once a year. And below is just see some examples. And as you can see here, most of them will be paid their dividends quarterly. This doesn't mean if someone is paying 2% dividends per year that you will receive this every 3 months. They will divide this 2% in 4 portions, means 0.5% will be paid out every 3 months. So then the sum of this 4 months is the total dividends. What types of dividends are available? There are stock dividends and non-cash dividends. I think mostly people will decide to, or most stocks, most companies will pay out this every as a cash dividend. And what is important to know if you start trading dividends? What are the main things what you need to know before you start? This is to select or to find companies who pay out dividends. There's a good scanner or watch list in the TWS, which I will show you later. And then a very important day you need to know is the ex-dividend day. This is the day when the stock opens with the minus of the dividend. For example, let's say as stock closes today at $20.30, and tomorrow is the ex-dividend date, and the dividend will be 20 cents. Then tomorrow, the opening price of the stock will be just 20 cents lower than the closing price of today. Maybe even lower than this, because there's also normal gaps. But ex-dividend date is the important day where you need to have this stock in your portfolio. Means if tomorrow is an ex-dividend day for, let's say General Motors or Verizon, that's just an example, then I need to buy the stock today to get the dividend. And the dividend is not automatically paid on the day where we call so ex-dividend date. Is normally a little bit later, but you will also find this information, and I will show you later how to find this in the TWS. So, the last slide before we go directly to the DWS platform is how are dividends taxed? Depends, of course, on a private person or if it's a company. Private person must tax dividends as income from capital assets with the final withholding tax. Normally, there's also something important if you receive an dividend from a US company, you will be taxed from the US tax, and then at the end, you will get the difference back. Let's say in your country, it's the tax is lower than what you paid in the US. You will receive some money back if you overtaxed or if you paid too much tax. We will also have the time, I think, to show you this information and where to find it. But now I want to go to the TWS platform. If you have any questions during the webinar, you can always use the chat function in GoToMeeting. And now you should be able to see the TWS platform. So first of all, if you go to a new window, there's under fundamentals, you will find the dividend calendar. What will show you the dividend calendar for the symbol or the stock which you opened here in the chart. We can try this and just go back to one very famous company who's paying, I would say a good dividend. If you open this window, you will have the following overview. There's historical. You can see the last 5 years, all the dividend payouts of Verizon. You will see, first of all, the ex-dividend date itself. There's a declaration date. It's not really important to know when this will be declared. I think most important for you before you invest is the ex-dividend date. The payment itself, that's exactly what I told you in the beginning. It depends. Normally, it's like a few weeks later, up to one month. You can see ex-dividend date for Verizon was here in April, 9th of April, and the payment was 1st of May. And then you can see the amount. So it's also interesting if you have a look on this historical data to see how the dividend increased or decreased in the last years. So you can have a good overview about the last, I think this is more than 20 payout dates to see exactly the dividend amount. So then we also see here the dividend grow and the payout in total about the last 12 months. That's I think with 4.1% for Verizon always very stable and a very good dividend yield. Of course, it will always change if the price is going down. Let's say dividend or Verizon announced already a payout for the next dividend of 0.615 USD, but Verizon will drop to, I don't know, maybe to $30. At the moment, it's as we can see it here around 60. Then, of course, the dividend yield will increase because it's always calculated with the last price. And especially if there's one stock what went down in the last 12 months a lot. And as we showed you in the beginning, there's a payout every 3 months, and the 12-month dividend is calculated by all these four payouts. Then sometimes you have a really high or crazy dividend yield, what can be higher than 10 or 12%. So just make sure that you always have a look at this historical data, and of course you will also check the chart and how this stock was going up or going down in the last 12 months. So this is historical. I think upcoming, this might be the most interesting part for you, because here you can exactly see when is the ex date, the ex dividend date, and you can set this to your calendar, or just highlighted that you know on which dates you need to have this stock in your portfolio. Of course, if you're a buy and hold investor, then you don't care about this ex-dividend date, because this will be always in your portfolio, and unless you will not close this position. But if you just want to create a dividend portfolio without holding the stock the full year, we will show you later some really interesting examples how to do so, or how to create a dividend portfolio. Let's make maybe another example before we show you some templates or some watch list where you can find the best dividend stocks for the US, and also some other interesting things, how to create a dividend portfolio and what might be like some interesting points to add to your dividend portfolio. The other stock I'm checking now is AT&T. It's same industry like Verizon. It's also telecommunication. You have here historical data as well. You see also the last 5 years upcoming as well. But for me, most important, I can see here the 12 months dividend yield, what is like not only slightly higher, it's almost a double dividend of Verizon. So if you have two stocks from the same industry, or where you need to decide which might be better for my stock portfolio, you can always have a look here at this portfolio, sorry, at this dividend calendar, which will bring you all the information related to dividends. And the same if you're not sure if a stock is creating a payout for dividends, you can say Facebook, for example, just add the stock and you will see there was only one. Yeah, no, this was only a spin-off. Facebook or Apple, they don't really pay out dividends, but we will show you later which are good examples for it. Oh no, I'm actually wrong. Apple pays out a dividend for the last 5 years, same, and here also you have the upcoming. But if you see the amount of the yield of the dividend is only 0.6%, so it's yeah, it's not comparable with stocks like Verizon or AT&T. That's the first thing. And if you work in this mosaic version of TWS, you can create like a scanner or like a watch list for dividends. And you normally have here predefined watch lists. For example, let's have a look. There's sorry, dividend in US. This is created by me, but if you go to Market Scanner, you can see there are a lot of different scanners already included, and one is dividend yield. So you can just open up this. I will show this one more time. So just click on the plus and then Mosaic Market Scanner, and if you scroll a little bit down, you will. So no, here dividend yield. You can also include like other regions. This is normally for the US. So let's dig on this. Then I can explain you exactly which information you will find in this predefined list, what is here the value of the total expected payouts of the last 12 months per share. And this is exactly what I told you in the beginning. Nobody will pay out dividend of 90%. Just we need to check here this symbol, and we should hopefully see what happened to this this is exactly what I told you. If there's like a big movement, this share was like 12 months ago almost $4 or $5 from the price. Now it's only a few cents or 70 cents. And if you calculate all the last 12 months together, then this can be this can happen that you see a dividend yield what is crazy high. And I would recommend to not check for the highest dividend in the yield. Just for like some basic things, you can also pre-div or you can edit the scanner. If you don't want to see the highest yields, you can also customize this. And this is, oh, sorry, I need to reopen this. You can see the button here, edit scan, and then it will show you exactly which fields we are scanning. For example, dividend till 90%, and let's say we only want to see till 10%, and then you can really get this information or like this amount of dividend what you're looking for. If you really are buy and hold strategy, yeah, maybe you should look for stocks with a dividend between 2% and 5%, because all this crazy high dividend stocks, they, like I said, already went down a lot, or they are so volatile that's difficult to trade them or to keep them in a portfolio. So it's easy to edit scanner. Also, not only to the dividend itself, it can also be added to the price. You can say that there should be only the price of I don't know, stocks between $5 or $10, and you can even export the results through Excel or to a watch list, what makes it more convenient to work with your favorite dividend stocks. I will decrease it a little bit more to see just these examples what are really interesting for us. Let's say 8%, that's what we saw in AT&T. And now we can check a few of these symbols, and I will tell you exactly. Still a lot. Just a second, then we will go also price. Don't want to trade anything below $5 and nothing above $100. I think now we will get a little bit closer to what we are looking for. And if it's still too much, we can also do this till 7%. Okay, let's go to a few examples or back to the scan itself. Like I told you, this the last price, I think, is pretty clear. The instrument or the symbol itself, the change is only rated for the actual trading day. And then the dividends is the total value about the last 12 months, not the quarter dividend payout. It's the full payout for the last 12 months. Let's check this symbol NABI, and then we can go again to our fundamentals and dividend calendar. You can see it's for every 3 months 16 cent. The next eight payouts are already declared, and It's a very good example because the ex-dividend date is the 3rd September, so it's next week. And this example will, with this symbol, I want to show you the example how to invest in a stock like this. So the easiest way is just to buy it and keep it till the ex-dividend day is over. This is one example. Another one is to do this with options. You can see the price here is $9.14, and I can. It's just a second. I open the option chain for this symbol, and I can see it's only available till 18 September. So in this case, the easiest, I will just buy 100 shares of N. What's the exact name? Just a second. This was another very important instrument. I think we showed this earlier in one of our webinars as well. If you go to Finvis website and you type the symbol there, you will have also all the informations, not only for the dividend, but for everything else together on one side. We can see here the payout of dividends is the total, this 0.64 cents. Then we have 7.3% as a dividend per year. And normally there should be also mentioned, no, this is only earnings. The ex-dividend date is not mentioned here. But you can see also credit services and all other important news what you need for this symbol. And to give you the example, or go back to the option trading, if I calculate the stock is the price is $9, I will receive 0.64 cents per year as a dividend payout. So in total, this is like 7%, what we already saw on Finviz. But if we want to make an example, I will just go ahead and buy 100 shares. Submit the order. So now I have 100 shares of this financial institute, and we saw the ex-dividend date is next week. And if I want to, let's calculate 7.5. So what I can do, I can sell a call option, what gives me an extra premium on top of this. So I will get the quarterly dividend and as well the premium of my call option, what is so-called covered call. So in total, depends if you want to sell it for $10, you will get another 10 to 15 cents on top of this, and you can do this almost every month. So in combination, I just will give you a few facts for it. If you decide to buy 100 shares of a stock, always consider to place a covered call as well. On top of the dividend, it will give you minimum the same payout on the whole year, what you get as a dividend. In total, it will make this buy and hold strategy for dividends much more, or with a much better performance than only keep it in your portfolio. You can create an extra income. And if you want to see more details related to covered calls or to options, you can see one of our videos, which should be implemented now on top of it with our card, where you can see all information regarding covered call and option trading. So in this example, I will just try to do this a little bit more conservative. I will sell this option for $7.50, what means lower than I purchased my stock. But in this case, it really doesn't matter because, let's see, I just want to Create the dividend. So we will just wait till this will be filled. So to make another example, what we already spoke about is AT&T. Let's see if we find any other symbol what we might know all. For example, GDV. It's now exactly the same. You go to fundamentals and you open the dividend calendar, and you see here even more data than for the last symbols what we had. They already announced the upcoming dividend for the next almost 2 years, the amount at least, and the ex date is also mentioned here. So this is depending on the company, it's not always the same, but the dividend calendar will give you quite an easy and perfect overview about all the informations you need for dividend trading or for creating a dividend portfolio. And in the beginning, in our slide, we also discussed the different ways. I think mostly or most people, they will decide to create a cash out or a payment as cash. But in TradeStation Global or in Tactive Broker, you can also go to your account management. And under user or account settings, what I will show you now, you can decide if you want to do this as a reinvestment, because it's also possible to invest this this dividend payout in for reinvestment, what means you will create or you will receive new stocks. We will just do this example for the stock what we bought recently. So you can see it here. This is settings and account settings, and then on the right hand side you will find dividend election. For this account we had like a reinvest, and if you go to this configure button you can always change it. I can change to receive cash. There's a little difference in the taxation, because if you reinvest it, it will not be taxed till you sell this position. But if you do this cash or to choose the cash payout, then it will, like we discussed in the beginning, taxed first by the US, and then you will maybe get a refund if the tax of the US is higher than in your country. So yeah, go to settings in your account management and then account settings, and you will find this on your right hand side, and you can always change this. And then we will just go back to our stock which we purchased in the beginning. We know it's 16 cents per share, so I bought 100 shares, what means I will receive a payout of $16. And if I go to reinvest, it means you only can receive one new share, because $16 and then price now is $9, means that I can only, or I will only receive one new share. The rest will be a cash payout, because normally never, it's never exactly the size of 2-3 shares. If you choose like a reinvest, just make sure you will see this on your statements. There should be some part as a reinvestment and the other part you will see it as a cash payout. So now our call option is also also got executed, because I bought the call option on $7.50 for this expiration date, 18th of September. What does it mean? It means at the end only one thing, that I, let's make a short horizontal line. It means at the end that I'm on the safe side as long as the stock of NAVI is not falling below $7.50. I received, I can change it a little bit lower. Oh, sorry. So I just need to make sure the next days till the expiration day is will it will not go below this price, because then I will automatically sell it for $7.50. So now you can say, okay, then you make a loss of $1.65, but this is exactly the premium which I will receive for which I received already for my call option. So at the end, it's a covered call deep in the money. What brings me the safety that I will not make any loss as long as this stock not is not falling below $7.50. I will just receive this this dividend as a reinvestment. So to just show it one more time. What will happen on the 3rd September, if I still have it in my portfolio, I will get this payout on the 18th of September, and on the 18th of September I should receive either $16, 100 multiplied by 16 cent, or I receive one stock as a reinvestment and the rest as a cash payout. So I think with this example, we also added some great or some good information related to dividends. Maybe one last example before we go over to all the your questions. If there are some from your side, we will present another famous company for dividends. What is Kraft Heinz with the symbol KHC? And here I also want to get this information in the dividend calendar, the historical, the ex-dividend date. The last one was the 27th of August. What is today? Exactly, what is today? So payout will be 25th of September. So everyone who had Kraft Heinz before today will receive this 40 cents. And here we can see yesterday it closed. Oh, sorry, this is always a little bit confusing. Yesterday we closed around $35.30, and today it opened on the ex-dividend day a little bit lower. It's not always exactly the size of the dividend, because you know there can be also normal up or down gaps, but you just need to know also if you trade some other products on a stock, when is the ex-dividend date, because only this stock will make the make it available, will make it available that you receive the dividends. If you have a call option or put option or anything related to the stock, you will not receive the dividend. So just to make sure that you also check this information if you trade any other products, because it's quite an important or interesting day for trading, even if you just do a swing trading or short-term trading. So, and if there's anything else, you can always send us an email or go to our website to see the upcoming dates for webinars. Also, you can give us a call, and we are happy to answer your questions in the next minutes. But for now, that's everything from my side. If you want to see or not miss any of our videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. So I'm happy that you will join some of our next webinars or watch of our some of our next videos. Thanks for your attention, and see you next time.